Hi, today we are with Max Spiers again, and we are recording only the voice because we don't have a good place to record the camera, hello, Max.
Hi, Alec, how are you?
Perfect. And you?
I'm doing very well, thank you. Yes.
Good. Yesterday you came back from Cyprus and...
Yes, I did.
So what happened there?
You know what happened there. It was very, 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 very hot all the time. It was very hot. It was, I'd never been there before. So it was a whole new experience. What I didn't know about Cyprus is that it was Richard the Lionheart's space, and that he had a castle there. So I visited his castle there. And I have connections to Richard the Lionheart. So it's
Lionheart was the who was he, the king of England?
He was prince.
Prince.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And he had some place in Cyprus?
Yeah. Of all things. Of all things, yeah.
Okay. And what kind of place is that?
Don't ask me too many questions about old Dickie, but I know that he did found the place, and his castle, which is right on the, I was on the northern tip of Cyprus, and you can see, actually as you're coming in from the ocean, you can see the castle as you're coming in, and I got a chance to touch it, and like feel the energy of it, and it just being a very powerful place, you know, connected to Elizabeth the First as well, an amazing place. Just an amazing place.
Okay, and when you were there, you were also during the day 7/7/2016.
Yeah, what? There was a very extremely significant day. It's funny, I wasn't even thinking about that. That event was a false flag event, I believe, but it was done in such a way to cause massive human heart attack, basically. The human heart was attacked, probably one of the worst since 9/11. If it was false, a false flag, it wasn't, you know, it wasn't specific, you know, it wasn't done randomly. This was a big, another big setup. And then just so happened there'd be, you know, a crop circle appear very near Stonehenge, which you know, I showed you the picture, which you know, you can put up on there, with the crescent moon, the seven rays, and the five sort of rays within the seven rays. I'm not sure why more people aren't making a big deal about that. I hope. I don't know why people are not making a big deal out of it, but it was a huge deal. And also, you know, at that time, you know, with Dallas being a very significant spot for me, because that was my home for a long time. And you know, the UK being, you know, obviously, you know, my home as well. And 7/7 being a very significant number as well, it being a Crowleyan number. So it seems to me, once again, like 9/11, they're being they're using Crowleyan rituals again to attack the human heart.
Yes.
Yes.
Dallas. What else? Actually, you said false flag.
Yeah, that word is thrown around a lot, isn't it? It's thrown around a lot. What does false flag really mean? I think it means a contrived event. An event set up to cause or invoke sadness within the human heart, or sadness within the human being. And, you know, it did. The actual crop circle is very similar to the Cyprus flag, apart from the crop circle being seven-pointed star, and yes. then within the seven-pointed star, there were seven rays.
Yes.
So you have seven and seven, and then around the outside of the seven and seven, you have like a binding chain, like a chain around it.
Mm-hmm.
And then the crescent moon pierces the chain around it and makes four pierce marks through it. So I'm not sure exactly why there was four as well involved, but four is involved as well.
Mm-hmm. And how do you relate that crop circle with Dallas?
I really don't know. That's something I've been thinking about since it happened. I don't know the full answer to that question.
Okay.
I know that Texas is a very central point of the planet. It having an X in the name is very important. X is symbol for, one of the many symbols of the moon. Not too many other states in the United States have the letter X in it either. It is very central.
Mm-hmm.
Texas is a very central state, almost like the axis of the United States. So bending the axis, all the shooters of the murder, all the shooters were wearing green as well, and all the murderers were police too.
Of JFK.
No, I'm talking about this present 7/7 killing.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, all the people that were killed were police.
Mm-hmm.
Especially with the gun laws being pushed at the moment, trying to pull the guns from the people. So you have, you know, I mean, it's been done for years, obviously, in the UK, but now it gives, you know, another very good reason in their minds, oops, to take away the guns from the people. And funnily enough, that's in, I'm not exactly sure if I'm right, but 1937, Hitler also took the guns from the people. Mm. And that was the next step to then force martial law.
Mm-hmm.
Take the guns from the people, then attack allow martial law to be implemented.
Yeah. Okay, a Presidio case, what is that?
The Presidio case. In San Francisco, it's a huge, it's such a huge topic. They found a lot of preschools and a lot of churches and a lot of kindergarten places for young children to play, interconnected with small tunnels, big enough to crawl through, more child size than adult size.
Yes.
And each one of the tunnels linked one to the other.
Mm-hmm.
So, and there was one or two central areas. This is more, Douglas Dietrich knows the very specific details about that. But I have the feelings connected to it rather than the details.
Okay.
Because of I, for one, myself, am more of a feeler of what happened than I am a detailed person. I just know that what went on there was unbelievably heinous, and Presidio was, Aquino was completely clean. He has no record of doing anything wrong. He was acquitted on every level of doing anything wrong.
Okay. Explain also who is Michael Aquino.
Yeah. Okay. I'll tell you what. There are plenty more people out there now who know a lot more detail about this gentleman than I do. I just know him from his energy signature. I know him from the astral plane. I know him from seeing him on the astral plane multiple times.
Mm-hmm.
He seems to have a disdain for me. He doesn't like me very much. He knows very well who I am. I think that there will be at some point a showdown between him and I. I think we'll meet in 3D.
Mm-hmm.
I think we probably have already, but yeah. For some reason, when his name comes up, I get a not particularly good feeling associated with him.
Okay, so who is he, and why is this name Aquino?
Right. He first letter A, last letter O. So
yes.
We have Alpha to the Omega.
Yes.
So we have we have a full controlling system. He likes his name to be pronounced A Queen O. This is once again an inversion of sexuality by. I just felt a surge of positive energy helping me out there when I said that A to the O. So they, whoever they are, want. Okay, so we're looking at the Alpha Draconian Queens, the Draco Prime. They are feminine, negative feminine in nature, anti male. It couldn't be more anti-male to the point of getting rid of the female gender completely, getting rid of them and placing a womb within the male and having male create babies rather than the female.
Or in artificial way.
They like it better if it's done through the male itself, because then it's closer to being an actual Baphomet.
Uh-huh, okay.
And they want the new world order to be an actual physical being, and rather than a, you know, created an environment like that.
Uh-huh.
So then it would be a literal Baphomet.
Okay, you said a Draconis Prime, Draco Prime.
Draco Prime, yeah.
And what is this animal, actually?
Yeah. You anyone can look at pictures if you put in the Baphomet. Baphomet.
Yes.
You have a perfect androgynous creature.
Yes.
That's them.
Okay. So there are many. There are more than one of these. Of those.
Yes. There's plenty more than one. Yeah. There's many of them.
And he's the chief of them.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah.
you look like being attacked now.
I feel like this part here is almost being like something's going like this to my throat. To a head in my head.
You can hear this?
Heard it.
You heard it?
Yeah, those words.
Okay, so we can say more. What is a basso?
It's a tool. It's the tool.
Yeah, explain the name.
Well, whatever you saw, you've seen, haven't you?
Yes.
If you've seen it, what did you? What was it you saw? Buzz. Buzz. What buzzes? Buzz. Bees buzz. If you think about bees buzzing, the Merovingian symbol is the beehive.
Yes.
Thank you for holding space for me there. I felt that, and it was easier. It's just another right brain way of explaining, you know, what it is they're doing. They like to tell you as a two reasons. One, it's arrogant for them to tell you what they're doing.
Yes.
You know. And two, it's like we're telling you what we're doing, and you're not doing anything about it. So it's like they're laughing at you. They think it's funny that they can go ahead and do what they're doing, and you don't do anything about it. That nobody's doing anything about it. I felt that feeling again. Yeah. So it's scene. Buzz scene. It's not to do with what is the buzz saw? A buzz saw is like you cut, right? I think.
Cut wood with it,
don't you?
Yes,
you
can cut wood with a saw.
Yeah, wood. Would you go there?
Hollywood.
Very, very good. So we have scene, Hollywood, saw, scene, saw, Hollywood. That's some very good stuff there.
Okay, and Michael Aquino has a special army.
Yeah. Well, he was, and I think there's some people who will debate that. He was one of the three generals. They have three at one time. Thank you again for the opportunity for me to speak. I don't get too much of a platform to say these particular things, because usually I wouldn't be talking about things like this, because it's a very, very fringe and touchy subject. But anyway,
his army are who?
Okay. Now, who are they? They are. I don't think all of them work for him, but I think a large proportion of the 72 Goetian demons are working alongside. Remember, the Goetian demons will all betray each other. Regardless, because that's their nature.
Okay, explain the word Goetian, because it's not easy to find this on Google. Oh. Goetian, this word.
Okay. Then you've caught me off guard, because I wouldn't know how to give you a full explanation of that. Mm-hmm. They are the kings, the dukes, the princes of what some might call quote unquote hell, which is the lower fourth frequency. They give themselves titles, and they work for heinous acts. So, if you want a profession, if you want a successful profession, you would go immediately to one of these particular Goetian demons, who are. Each one is specifically for a
specific subject.
Yeah. So each one represents a different. One is legal. One would be perhaps to do with fighting and I'm just trying to think. They're all very, very, very specific, mm-hmm. you know. Anything to do with legality came up is because I was looking yesterday and I was looking up. The name came up. Baal's name at the moment comes up a lot. Baal, B-A-L-E. And I noticed that Cain and Abel. Now, if you look at Abel, and you know they make out that Cain is the bad one and Abel is the good guy. Mm-hmm. But if you just switch the letters around of the name Abel, mm-hmm. you'll get Baal.
Yes.
Right. And I think possibly. We might have been tricked with the Cain and Abel story there, him being Abel being Baal, and it being flipped, the whole script being flipped around the other way. Mm-hmm. If you look at the actor who played Batman. Christian Bale. Now, if you look at his name, you have Christian, and then you have Baal.
Yes.
Playing Batman. Batman is Baphomet Man.
Or Bad Man.
Bad Man or Baphomet Man. Mm-hmm. So there's an interesting wordplay in there. And so, especially with the new movie Batman versus Superman, I mean, it's, and then all of a sudden you have Catwoman, who also wears all black, and
yes.
and comes in and tries to kill, sort of like the savior. It's you know. Christopher Nolan, the director Christopher Nolan, very very clever man, and showed a lot of information within. Sorry, my throat again is being completely.
Taken over.
Mm-hmm.
Release it.
It's like a numbing agent. It's like you know when you if you have tooth trouble, and you put stuff on your teeth to numb you like that, feels like that. Yeah. And my face feels on fire.
Okay, the topic of Canterbury.
Okay, so the word Canterbury, if you take the ER out, Queen Elizabeth the First, or Second, sorry, Second, her name is Elizabeth Regina is her actual name, right? Mm-hmm. That's her. So she's from the Saxe-Coburg-Gotha line, right? Her name is not Windsor. That was a made-up name to sound as English as possible. Windsor.
Yes.
Sounds very English, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Windsor. Now, where do we go? Where do we go with that?
Windsor.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. We'll pick up tomorrow.
Elizabeth.
Sorry, what did you say?
Elizabeth Windsor.
Yes. Well, I mean, and also, you know, in her name, L. Elizabeth, you know, it's
reptile.
Right. Yeah. We talked about last time about how she's a 4,000-year-old...
7,000.
7,000-year-old multi-bodied. I think she was the first Liz too. I think she was the same woman. I also think that Elizabeth Taylor also is connected deeply to that too. Now, obviously, it's difficult to tie that in because they're both alive at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to ask me
again. Canterbury.
Oh, that's right. That's where. Okay, now her name, Elizabeth Regina, right? That's her name.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so Canterbury. If you take the ER out of the word, you have the two words, can't bury.
Yes.
So you almost have, it's almost saying in immortality.
Yes.
Now, for me, my flip from one, you know, Canterbury, to the other one, within a month period of time, and having no plan whatsoever to even go to that country, and in circumstances, threw me straight there. I stayed there for 4 years. And
okay, break. Hello, today we are meeting with Max Spiers again for the third time. Hello, Max. We tried to record this interview a few hours ago, but then because we were talking about very uncomfortable stuff for some bad guys, they attacked you and we had kind of removal of your consciousness for some time. You felt bad, but now you are back. Yeah?
Yes.
So, what did you feel? What happened? Please explain.
What happened? I mean, I think I disassociated, and then
But don't go into the state, just explain.
and then basically that's what happened. And that I hate that state, and it's something to be worked on, and that's what happened.
Good. So now we're starting recording this again. So the first topic, let's
I'm
talk
quite
about
tired, so just letting you know.
Yeah, you're tired, yeah. Let's talk about the presidial case.
Oh, okay, presidio. Okay, okay. Like I said, there are others who know a lot more about the details of what happened at presidio, but what I know was that this was a highly complex, highly complicated, very efficiently done a network system of tunnels underneath the ground, put together, small tunnels, yeah, put together to take children from morning, when there was a period of time in the day, at morning, lunchtime, or at the end of school, or if there was a detention period, they would take them and then kidnap the children, and children would be taken. And they would gather specific children up and sexually abuse them, disassociate them, and abuse them. And this would go on.
Where was that?
That particular one was in San Francisco.
San Francisco. Okay, and it was discovered when?
I think mid-70s.
Mid-70s, okay.
Yes, you want to hold this?
Yes, okay. Let's hold this. And the attack happened basically because we were talking about Michael Aquino. Who is this guy?
Who's that guy? How do you summarize that man?
Yeah, summarize in a few sentences.
Yeah, okay. He goes by doctor Michael Aquino. He's a colonel in the army
and a general.
Right, a general. Whether or not he's a doctor, I don't know. But he, and I've heard him go by doctor, Doctor Aquino. I don't know whether he is or not.
Okay.
Whether he has a PhD, whether or not, I don't know. He's a colonel. He backhanded for that one. He's a colonel. So what they fought and won a case to if Christians could have a minister come into the army and preach the gospel.
Yes.
Then they fought and won a lawsuit saying that Satanism, they should be allowed to have Satanism to come in, and to come in and do that there, and he would so come in and do an hour on. I don't know. I would assume probably Saturday, not a Sunday, because Saturday is Saturn day, and them being worshipping Saturn, they probably did an hour of worship on Saturn. Saturday.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And his surname, Aquino, what's the meaning of that?
So, you know, understanding that he pronounces a queen. Oh,
yes. Alpha and Omega.
Alpha, the Alpha and the Omega. A queen in the middle. In the middle, it starts with an A. Remember the letter A is really a pyramid, but a capstone. And the letter O is the sun.
Okay.
So you have a pyramid with a capstone.
The capstone of the pyramid.
The letter A is that's what that stands for, and then O is the glyph for the sun. So you have the Alpha, which is the first, and the Omega, which is the last, And then you have Queen in the center, which is inverted because it was the father. It's supposed to be the father, son, and so him putting the, he's him representing, you know, the Queen, the mother. And so he has it that way around. He was there. He's a very, very smart man. He's a clever guy. And has spent Mind Wars, if you have a look at, it's worth having a look at that book.
Mm-hmm.
You should have a look at that book. It's ingenious what he put together there.
Is he a human being?
No, not even close, no. No. He's a hermaphrodite.
Okay.
In human form. He'll love that, me saying that. He will always enter the field when you start talking about him. So if you talk about him, he'll be around.
He came here
yeah,
now?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just show him the middle finger.
Yeah. I remember he likes negativity, so he will he'll absorb
so
that.
So show him love.
Right. That he doesn't like. But there are certain ones that if you project love towards them, they get very aggressive at you.
Mm-hmm.
Makes them very aggressive.
Good.
That's my flower.
And you said he is not a human being, so
no.
Who is he?
Yeah, good question. I have seen him as I hope everything's okay, you guys. I'm just tired, so it's not a normal interview. This one is isn't a normal interview. I just came back and been traveling for the last 2 days, so it's a little bit different. But the information I'm trying to get across is the truth. And I have had experiences with this gentleman a number of times, and I think it's very important that I say this and that everybody hears this, because he is alive and well, continually doing. Doing what he's doing, and he's harming children.
Mm-hmm.
Continually, daily.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And his wife?
Yes, she's involved. Yes.
They both.
She's anti. She's anti-female.
So anti-female. What do you mean?
She represents everything that womankind doesn't.
Mm-hmm.
So she represents everything that, you know, nurturing and love and all those things that the female represents.
So
she represents
opposite.
The opposite of that. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay, next topic, Buzz Saw.
Yeah.
Who is this guy?
I don't know him, but I just know what he does. And I know what he stands for, I know what he represents. Because he's another one to very easily read. And I don't buy into liars. I'm not here to point fingers and say or witch hunt or attack like that. I'm just here to explain that for one, things are not even close to what they seem to be.
Okay, maybe let's start this topic again, because...
Am I go off track or something?
Because I don't understand what you mean.
Yes.
Really?
Okay,
yes.
So...
Open the last one.
I
don't know.
When you want to
breathe. Breathe, breathe. White lies. Look how many, you know, nice people like you.
Oh yeah, I'm very lucky. Yeah, I'm very lucky.
You are very lucky, always.
You scratch my back then.
Yes, I can scratch.
Properly then. Thank you. Middle. So he was initiated by seeing information. So seeing stone temple pilots.
Okay, so let's.
Oh, I just realized something I didn't realize before. That's. I just worked something else out. Okay.
Okay, let's start it. Temple. This topic. Okay, older stone.
Oh my god. The name. Just. Sorry, let's throw in my crystal. Watch out. Yeah. Okay. Temple.
Yeah, stop. Stone. Let me start. Okay. Let me start.
Okay. They've encoded the whole thing. The whole thing is encoded. The whole show and his name.
And skull. Also skull.
Sorry?
Skull.
Well, that's just. No, it's temple.
Yeah, temple is here, but the skull is. Oh, whatever. Let's start.
Yes, it's not in there, but anyway.
Oliver Stone. The next topic. Mm-hmm. The next topic. Oliver Stone. This name comes from what?
Olive. The olive branch that was left on the ark. On the ark, an olive branch was brought to show that land was still found. Right. Yes. That land was found. Mm-hmm. And that was to say, hey, look, you know, they've been traveling on the boat for however long, and the land was found, and that was like good news, right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But
and the surname, his surname, Stone.
His real name is Silverstein, right?
Silverstein, yeah. Which is Silver Stone.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which is the moon.
Yes, which is the moon. Yeah. Which really isn't a moon.
Mm-hmm. Right?
It's not a satellite.
Yeah.
It's placed there. It was put there.
Okay. So, Oliver Stone, which is O-S.
Mm-hmm.
Oz. Osiris.
Osiris, yes.
Yeah. Mhm.
Yes.
And then his son is.
Yeah, Sean.
Sean Stone.
Yes, seen.
Mhm.
Yes. Thank you.
So explain this. This play on words. Seen stone. Seen means that I saw something.
Yes, it does mean that. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You have to go through rites. First of all, to this symbol here. I'll send you a photograph of. If you want, of this symbol here, and of
yes, let's explain. When you point, point to your head on the side,
temple.
You point to the temple.
Yes,
and you have the temple stone, or the stone temple.
There's a band, okay, they were called Stone Temple Pilots. I don't know if you've ever heard of them before.
Uh-huh.
Have you heard of them before?
No.
Okay, well, the lead singer, his name was Scott Weiland, okay?
Mm-hmm.
He's died recently. I used to know him, I briefly knew him. He was a great singer, and a bit of a maniac, really, but a funny guy, and genius, and very interesting fellow. Often those types are amazing. I did two times. I I stayed in a place that he was staying in, and we missed each other a couple of times. A couple of times we didn't miss each other, and got some time to spend with him.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and the name Sean Stone, Sean Stone, mm-hmm. actually, mm-hmm. Is related to the words basso. Basso. Why bass? It's called the word. Where is this word bass from?
I was just telling myself I never heard that word before.
Bass. Mm. Wake up.
I'm here. I'm thinking.
You said you didn't know the word buzz.
No.
Bees make buzz.
Buzz. They make buzz, not baz. That's all. Buzz, baz. Vowels are interchangeable. Yes.
Uh huh.
Buzz. Okay. Where'd you get buzz or baz from that though? From
Baz, so
yes, yeah. Okay, so let's look at where are you getting Baz? Where are you getting Baz from?
You told me that.
Right, why? You have to remind me.
Baz, so. So is C.
Baz.
Yes.
Yes. You said basil. You said basil, didn't you?
Maybe I mispronounced.
What's Basil?
The Tower of Basil.
Okay, Babel.
The Tower of Babel and Basel in Switzerland, in Basel.
Hmm.
It's the center. International Bank of Settlements, BSI, Bank of International Settlements in Basel, is the Tower of Basel.
Mm. Ooh, it's interesting. You've got the flames talking and interacting with you. That's amazing. Okay, so Sodom, there's a big connection to what's going on now and all of this, this and Sodom and Gomorrah,
mm-hmm.
okay, because what's happening now on this planet is sort of a reflection of Sodom and Gomorrah, mm-hmm. and the tarot card is sort of very much connected to that as well. And the tower is the Tower of Babel. It's a single tower,
yes.
And they had pushed everything to such an extreme on this planet that. That they had to literally kill themselves to be able to come back and live again, you know, because they had taken it to such an extreme.
Uh-huh. The single towers from the Babel, but
yes.
You have twin towers from the Temple of Solomon.
Yes.
Okay.
Boaz and Joachim, the two towers.
Exactly. And what about the army of Akino? It's also related to Tolkien's books.
So Tolkien, he doesn't like those books. I had a dream or something. Akino doesn't like those books. I don't know how I know.
Okay.
He never liked them and disagreed with them.
But his army is like those.
Yeah, similar. Yeah.
How do you call those orcs?
O-R-C.
Orcs. Okay.
Yeah.
So let's jump to Canterbury.
Okay.
First, the word Canterbury. What does it mean?
Right. This is interesting. If you take out the ER, it's a beautiful city, and a very, very important city in the world.
You live there?
Yes, I lived there for half my life.
Uh-huh.
It's significant because it's one of the oldest cities in oldest living cities. When I say living, because it was thriving and bustling and thriving and energetically thriving in 1,000 or 1,200 years ago, which is unusual because most of the cities in the UK and weren't. They were dead. They were coal mining towns,
mm-hmm.
and this was an elite. So like, it wasn't Catholic, and everywhere was Catholicism, and so Henry VIII, the man that he was, kept. England, that's good though. That's where a knife was in my back.
Yeah,
got stabbed in my back there.
Kept England.
Knife went in there. I think I was I'm connected to Beckett somehow.
Henry.
Yeah, I'm very connected to Henry.
Again.
Yeah.
Henry the Eighth.
Yes.
So again.
Yeah. He's not a bad fellow. He's not a bad man. He knew that they were trying to kill him, and I knew they couldn't kill him physically.
Yes.
Because there are some who incarnate here who can't be killed physically. It's impossible to kill them. That way.
Mm-hmm.
The only way is to...
Don't fade away.
The only way is to...
Alex.
Breathe.
Yeah.
Fade away.
Yeah.
Can you feel your throat? Is it okay?
Yeah. So Henry Ford. Henry Ford, the Church of England, because he didn't want Catholicism to be brought over to the UK.
What is happening to your throat?
I feel like it's being throttled.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, because a lot of this story here is tied into Henry.
Henry Even IV Buzzard, or Henry the Eighth? Which one?
Henry the Eighth.
But a few seconds ago you said Henry Ford.
No, he didn't say Henry Ford.
Yes, you said Henry Ford.
Mm-hmm. Henry Ford, perhaps. But not the Fourth. Henry the Fourth didn't do very much at all. He's a waste of space. Waste of time. He was useless. I wish he didn't even... He was an absolute waste of time. He was only on the throne for... I've been throughout there 9 years, that's 7 years. The influential monarchs are Henry VIII, Elizabeth I, Victoria, Edward VIII, even though he abdicated, it was still significant. obviously Elizabeth is the second now. William the First, Henry the First, William and Mary, which were the only two who were a couple that were both king and queen at the same time.
Okay, let's go back to the word Canterbury. So we removed ER from the middle and we have Canterbury, which means someone cannot die.
Right, it's immortal.
Immortal, So who is this one who is immortal? ER in the middle is her or her as man. So who is this ER?
Yeah, well, I can't. What do you want me to do? What do you want me to tell
this,
you?
This Canterbury is about whom? About the queen?
No.
So, about whom? Okay, break.
Okay.
Henry VIII, who was he?
Okay, Henry VIII wanted to stop the, didn't want the Catholic Church to take over the United Kingdom. He wanted to keep the Church of England as the rule, as the dominant religious... and fought to keep.
He wanted to be independent from Vatican.
Yes, completely. So he was constantly at war with that bloodline.
Yes.
If you just forget the fact that it's the Vatican and Henry VIII, it was two bloodlines at war.
Mm-hmm.
Henry, the Vatican is not a Merovingian line, and Henry is a Merovingian line. So there was two bloodlines fighting.
Yeah, but when he was dying, still he turned back to the Vatican, and since then on,
The Church of England is rules England, not the Catholic Church.
So why the Queen, the current Queen of England, kind of pays homage to?
Pays homage. I mean, in what respect? They now don't. They don't. They because the New World Order. They've all of the old infighting lines have now come together make the New World Order happen. So there's no more. It may seem like there's still infighting.
So you mean that the War of Roses is over or not over?
No, not over, no. Not really, no.
So how is it now?
That would be essentially they agree on the agenda that they want the 500 million and the elite hierarchical structure.
Yes.
But who is at the top of there? The white rose or the red rose is still at war.
Mm-hmm.
So the yeah.
So the
I would personally be behind the red rose, the red rose.
The name of the roses are Lancaster and
York.
York. So York, like the.
York
masonry from York,
right? Well,
and
within all of the secret societies, there's good and there's bad.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like within the York Rite, there are people who want humanity to be free, and don't want
really.
Yeah,
in the proportions. How many percent?
Very, 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 very small percentage within the York Rite that wants humanity to be completely free.
Mm-hmm. Yesterday you came back from Cyprus.
Mm.
What happened there? You were a few days there and you recorded some interview. Tell
I
me
did,
about it.
Yeah.
It was on 7/7.
Yeah, probably the most significant date to date outside of the 9/11 date. Yeah. First of all, 7/7 is a. There's a book by Crowley called 777, you can read the book, and you can get some Kabbalistic information. But if you put a mirror down the center diagonally of each page, you get 10 times more information than if you didn't.
Mm-hmm.
It's a double encoded book.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, you gave the interview, but you had some problems with the interview.
Yeah. Okay. So did I not tell you this?
No.
Okay. At 8:58. So the interview began at 9 p.m. and at 8:58. P.M. The entire town we were in Cyprus blacked out. Mm-hmm. Just all of a sudden, the entire town went black, everywhere.
So pitch
black.
Electricity was gone.
Yeah, from the entire town.
Mm-hmm.
And at 8:58, the Dallas shooting began.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
But. Okay.
Whether or not there is a time delay
is
sort of irrelevant because it's symbolic that okay, now if you look at 9/11, okay, 9/11, right? 1/1, if you take 1 and 1 off 9, you get 8:58.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you've got a you have this is a symbolic thing they were doing.
Yeah, 2 minutes
okay.
Before
9/11 represents Gaia. 9/11 is the number represents the number of the Earth, the heart.
Why you say Gaia? How? In what respect does it represent Gaia? Because 911 in the United States is also the emergency phone number.
Yes, it is. So what they're doing is they're doing a reversal again. They're using emergency as a number, which is actually a number of beauty.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay, again, why 911 is Gaia?
The reason why, I don't know why. The reason why it is... I don't know the answer to that question. I suppose it would be like asking why is Snickers 85 cents. I don't know.
Okay, so 2 minutes before 9, there was this blackout. How did you solve
it? Total blackout.
Yeah. How did you solve this?
I panicked for about an hour. I tried everything I possibly could. I tried every way I could, but there wasn't, because when you're there, Wi-Fi is the only way to connect. Even dialing in a number, I couldn't get through to them.
Mm-hmm.
So I literally had to go and just wait until... We drove to somewhere, and somewhere had a generator to power back up, and then it powered back up an hour later. And I got back on air and spoke for an hour about basically what we're talking about now. And I didn't know until the next day about the crop circle, which was very, very similar to the Cypriot flag.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And the circle was where?
The circle. So it was a. It was like a like a chain, almost like a chain, or a very, very perfectly interlinked chain around the outside of the crescent moon. mm-hmm. and a seven-pointed star.
Yes.
Now the seven-pointed star, the four points, pierced the crescent moon.
Mm-hmm. And it was near Stonehenge.
Yes, relatively. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay.
They're using the energy from Stonehenge to. I believe that it was a military created crop circle, not a UFO crop circle. I believe it was connected to the process church. The crop circle itself was the crescent moon was pierced by the seven-pointed star four times. So the process church believes in Jehovah, or in this order, Lucifer, Satan, Jehovah, and Christ. And they believe that Christ is, they believe that Christ is a messenger. They see Christ as a messenger, not as a ruler.
Mm-hmm.
So like Gabriel is a messenger, they see Christ as a messenger.
Mm-hmm.
Some do worship, some from the process church worship Christ. 97% worship the other three, with the vast majority worshipping Lucifer. Then Satan. Okay, Lucifer is... extreme sexuality. Satan is extreme violence. Jehovah is rule by a repression, and Christ being messenger.
Okay, we're talking about Canterbury, we forgot about this number 01227.
Yes.
Please okay, explain.
O being
yeah, but this number. What is this number? What does it represent?
Right. So
underground something.
Okay. So O being, if it's 01227, O being an orifice, one being a phallus, and 227 being a top heavy fraction of pi, which is 3.141.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Pi is critical to time travel in every mm-hmm. way. You have to have pi for time travel. And p is 2 in numerology, because it's 20th letter of the alphabet.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so time pp, which would be 22. Right, so then you have 22. So two of the four of the process church are necessary to create time travel.
Mm-hmm. So is there anything related to time travel under Canterbury?
Yeah, yes.
What is that?
They have the magnetic rail. That goes
shuttle.
Yeah, so that goes there.
And the number of the station is this number, yeah.
Yeah, it would begin that number. Yeah, all the taxis that go to the train station. There's two train stations at Canterbury East and Canterbury West. The taxis that go there are 01227666666.
The phone number or number of the taxi
The phone number, and on the side of every taxi it says 01227666666.
Super. Okay, and I think we covered everything. So, we forgot to explain. Michael Aquino is actually Draco Prime. What type of entity is that?
um, It would be yes, shut down there. It would be the ruling elite.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Top of the cream.
Yeah. Yeah.
So they must be scared now that we are talking about
them. Yeah, because I'm just exposing them. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So what else do you know about them?
That there aren't that many of them.
Mm-hmm.
There are very few of them.
How do they look like?
More like dinosaurs.
Uh-huh.
Not like T-Rexes, because T-Rexes don't exist or never existed like they say they existed.
Mm-hmm.
They just geometrically just don't fit at all.
Mm-hmm. How tall are they?
20 plus feet.
Mm-hmm. 7 meters, something like that.
Yeah, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Literally looking like
dinosaurs
coming out of a ship.
Mm-hmm.
If that makes sense.
People wake up, what would they do?
If a marine, a highly trained marine who's seen horrific things, would collapse and out of seeing one, then a regular person would probably go into a cardiac arrest or into a massive shock,
mm-hmm.
possibly death.
Yeah, but what would those Dracos do when people wake up and realize who was doing all the mess in the world?
What can they do? What can they do?
Run away, maybe?
Well, there's nowhere to run to. There's literally nowhere to run to.
Underground.
Thank you. How would they know where to go? Literally, there are some that do. There are some that do. There are some that have already worked out where it is. Worked out. I mean, there's who have insider knowledge of where the underground entrances are.
Mm-hmm.
There are plenty of them.
Mm-hmm.
There are plenty of them in Dover, actually. Dover is the corner point of the southeast of England.
Wales.
No.
Ah, okay. East. Yeah.
Yeah, as far as the White Cliffs.
Yes.
Right. They are
close to France.
It's 22 miles from France.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. So
there's a deep underground water base between Dover and Calais.
Mm-hmm.
There's another deep underground water base between New Haven and Dieppe as well.
And who lives there?
There's a military. But it's still hierarchically structured with Draco Prime down through to humans, the human there.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we finished all the topics. So for the wrap up, we need to say that this interview was very hard, because whenever we started some difficult topic, it looked like someone was attacking you or some program inside of you was triggered. How do you feel that? Which option was that?
I feel ashamed.
Mm-hmm. Why ashamed?
Because I know what happened to me, and because I know what happened, I have a great deal of shame associated with it.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, to be honest, Thomas, a lot of the time shut down.
Yes.
Shut down because of that, you know? Because there's a level of me that wonders why I wasn't protected from that. And then me thinking that starts to make me think, what else wasn't I protected about?
Yeah, and even now you have difficulties with speaking.
Yes, I know, it's funny, isn't it?
It's strange.
Yeah, it's got worse.
So what do you feel now in your throat?
Numb.
Uh-huh.
Not only that. Yeah, that's what it feels like.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so thank you for the interview, for sharing this difficult stuff.
You're very welcome.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thanks.
I mean that. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Thanks.
Yeah. Good stuff, Alex.